The question we're given asks us, how many students attended Einstein School in 2006? And in this little table, they tell us how many attended in 2001, 150 students, and then in 2002, 225. 2003, we had 300 students, but they don't tell us 2006. So what I think they want us to do is to see the pattern in how many students, the population of students grew by every year, and just assume that that pattern continues through 2006. So we need to figure out what the pattern is from one year to the next, and then we're going to figure out 2004, 2005, and then 2006. So the assumption that we're making in this problem, and I think that the problem wants us to make, is that whatever the pattern of growth was in these 3 years, that they continue all the way to 2006. So let's see what's happening here. When we go the first year, what happens to our student population? We go from 150 to 225 students. And the easiest pattern to think about is, well, just how much are we increasing by every year? So how much do we have to go to from 150 to 225? We increased, well, if you increase by 50, you get to 200, so we increased another 25, so we increased by 75 students. And then to go from 225 to 300, how many did we increase by? Looks like 75 again. 75 plus 225 is 300, so it looks like we increased by another 75. So the pattern here is that each year, 75 more students attend the Einstein School. So let's just continue that pattern. So let's add another 75. Let's add another 75 to the 300 in 2003, and we'll get 375 in 2004. If we assume the pattern continues, let's add another 75. Let's add another 75. And then what'll that give us? That'll give us 450 students in 2005 if we assume the pattern continues. And we're almost there. Let's add a final 75. 75 plus 450. If you add 50, you get to 500. So it's another 25. So it's 525. So that would be the answer to our question if we assume the pattern continued, that 525 students attended Einstein School in 2006.